Okay. One last thing to do is, all right, we've come up with two equations because of the two pivot points, but we've got four unknowns, so we need two more equations to solve for all of those forces.
Fundamental theorem of algebra.
Okay. We can still come back to what we did previously with the sum of the forces being zero, right? It's not going anywhere. So the sum of the forces in the x direction, that is going to involve the normal force in the positive x direction, and we're going to have T1 cos of 60 in the negative x direction, and those are going to sum up to zero. So there's one of the two equations.
Now, the important thing to address here as well is that previously we were looking at a rotating frame. We were defining our orientation axes based on that rotation. Now we're moving to an xy frame. And again, it's like it was before. You can always define your own orientation axes in this frame. To the right is going to be positive, to the left is negative. So when we look at the x direction, positive, negative.
Okay. We should have done that first. Okay. And then in the y direction, some of the forces are also going to be equal to zero, right? So here we've got T2 is pointing straight up. We've got T1 sine of 60 degrees will give us the y component of that. And we've got gravity going downwards. And in that case, the sum of the forces are zero.
So now we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 equations, as well as 1, 2, 3, 4 unknowns. So you can solve and come up with all those forces.
There we go. We're done.